Can I ask more broadly, just in terms of interest in the women's game here in the U.S.? As you know, it's grown exponentially over the course of your career, and that's been hard-fought, hard-earned on the back of a lot of incredible success. But this World Cup represents a chance for millions of more people, right, to be aware of the team, join the other legions of fans. I wonder if you can kind of reflect on this moment for women's soccer in the United States in terms of what's at stake in this tournament and for the years ahead.
This one does feel different than other World Cups. I think just in general, you know, the sort of like zoom out picture around women's sports right now feels like we're sort of out of the just like the dogged fight phase. Not that there's not a lot still to fight for, but, you know, the sort of acceptable cognitive dissonance and just denial of what we actually are and how incredible women's sports are, how popular it is, how profitable we can be, what the business actually is. I think those days are you know, pretty much long gone, and it's that would be a quite a tough and embarrassing position to still keep. So I think this one, this World Cup feels almost like a, you know, show up and show out kind of vibe. I think it's going to be incredible. I said before, I think that this World Cup is going to be incredible. Having it being co-hosted by Australia, New Zealand, huge sporting countries. You know, we've seen the numbers around ticket sales, just the quality on the pitch better than it ever has been. It feels like this is like a real opportunity for us. Actually, let me rephrase that. We've always taken the opportunity to show exactly who we are, not just our team, but the women's game in general. But it feels like a real opportunity to kind of like blow the lid off just in terms of fanfare and media and sponsorships and the sort of larger business around this sport. I think everyone is sort of hip to the game now and understands that this is, you know, not somewhere that's just like, oh, we should cheer for the Women's World Cup because that's the right thing to do. It's like, yeah, this is actually a terrible business move if you're not getting in on it, if you're not investing, if you're not putting resources to it, and if you're not tuning in, you're sort of missing out on a massive cultural moment in so many ways. And I think, as always with women's sports, like we're always doing both. And I think that's something that we're really proud of, and I think something that just totally differentiates us from a fan base perspective than any sort of men's sports, but I think also from a business perspective. I think we know that for bottom line, you know, equality is actually good in a shocking turn of events. Equality is actually good for business. And, you know, I think that that's something special that the women's game has. And this feels like, you know, the sort of premier event. I mean, it's the biggest women's sporting event in the world by far, bar none, as I've said. And I think that this is a real opportunity of sort of like a kind of paradigm shift globally. I mean, I think we're having it a lot in the U.S., but I think just globally, you've seen what's happened since last World Cup, whether it's stadium selling out or the Women's Final Four or, you know, Cricket League in India. Like, there's so many examples of this, and it feels like this is like a paradigm shift or a moment we'll look back to and say, like, nothing was ever the same after this Women's World Cup and what we're going to be able to do. And all bets on the Women's World Cup. Money's in on that. I just think it's going to be an incredible event. And as you said, it is hard fought and hard won by, you know, by us, by our players and our Players Association and, you know, our federation, you know, being on the right side of things now, but also to all the other teams and all the other vested interest happening in the Women's World Cup. I think everybody is thankfully pushing in the right direction and pushing in the same direction now, and sky's the limit from here.